Hi, this is Amy from the Altice store. Well, winter is finally over. Spring is here, the sun is out, and so I am finally going to be able to show you all of those demos that I've been promising you all winter. So what we're going to do is we're going to answer a lot of those questions that we get all the time, and instead of just telling you, we're going to actually show you. So we're going to put together a whole list of them, and we'll do a playlist, and we'll have it here so you can actually go and watch all of the common questions being answered. All right? So the first question that we get all the time is, I bought a great deal on a 20 or 24 volt solar panel and I want to use it to charge my 12 volt battery. What do I need to do? Well, the answer is you need an MPPT charge controller to reduce the voltage down to the right voltage to about 14 volts to charge the battery, but also increase the current on the output. So because watts or power equals volts times amps, if you drop the volts down to the right voltage for your battery bank, what's going to happen is if you use just a PWM charge controller, the volts are going to drop, the amps are going to stay the same, and so you're going to lose about half of the power. So what you can get with an MPPT charge controller is it will drop the volts but raise the amps. And so you're going to get more of that power from that solar panel to your battery. So let's take a look here. What I've got is I've got two identical 100 watt, 24 volt solar panels. And their short circuit current is about 3 amps, but their IMP, their maximum power current output, is 2.78 amps. And I did measure them both and they're both getting right about that amount of output. The VMP is 36 volts, so that's the max power voltage that it will be putting out and trying to charge a 12 volt battery. But you're not going to want to put 36 volts into a 12 volt battery. So what's going to happen is it's going to drop that voltage down to around 13.5 or 14 volts, depending on how you've got your charge controller set. And let's take a look at what happens. All right, so first I want to show you, this amp meter is actually measuring the output between the charge controllers and the battery. And you see on that minus 0.26 amps. What that is showing is that when the charge controller is actually up and running and working, it will actually draw a little bit of current. So the PWM really doesn't take much power at all. The MPPT, when it's active, is going to be using about a quarter of an amp. Now that does shut down fairly quickly. If it senses there's no solar coming in, it does shut down pretty quickly. But just keep in mind that the MPPT charge controller will actually use a little bit more power than the PWM. So keep that in mind. If you're considering using it on a very, very small solar panel, the increase of output may not be worth it if you're talking only about a quarter of an amp, okay? So let's actually turn off the MPPT charge controller. We're going to turn on the input to the PWM. So again, my IMP, my maximum power current is about 2.78, and I am actually seeing 2.83 amps output from the charge controller, the PWM charge controller. That's great. But my voltage, again, has dropped from 36 volts down to 13.2 volts because I'm charging that 12 volt battery. So that's really cut the output of that panel down dramatically. Now, let's go the other way. Let's actually turn on the MPPT charge controller. I'm just turning that on. So you see now it's actually dropped down to 0.03 amps. That is the MPPT charge controller dropped back into standby mode. So you know it's not going to be drawing the quarter amp all the time, but again, just kind of keep in mind that when it is actively working and actively charging, you are going to see a higher current draw than with the PWM. So we've got the MPPT charge controller turned on. We're going to turn on the input, and we now are seeing 5 amps coming out. So that voltage is 14.1 volts, so it's actually putting out a little bit higher voltage than the PWM one was. So 14.1 volts, and it's dropping down to 4.6 amps, kind of going all around, but anywhere between 4.6 and 5 amps output. That's pretty significant difference from the 2.8 amps we were getting from the PWM. So you can see how having a MPPT charge controller really does increase the output and gets you a lot more of the power out of your solar panel than if you were to just use a PWM. So using PWM pretty much cuts your solar panel in half, whereas the MPPT will really maximize your output. So I hope that's helpful. If so, give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our channel so that we can notify you when we've got new videos coming up. And make sure you go to our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.